Hello friends, this is Milton Knight again, and we are sharing a 1953 cartoon directed by Connie Rosinski. Beautiful background again, with the architecture of castles completely misunderstood. And then we have an unusually haggard-looking Pearl Pureheart. This scene is animated by Paul Sommer, who went back and forth between coasts and had a little bit more Disney charm than the usual Terry Toons animators. The crazy animator, it might be Rosinski here, but then it switches to Carlo Vinci, whose characters would move and then hold, and then like something like a mouth or a head would just keep going. Very 1, 2, 3. And here we have a group stoned knights with large teeth. Vinci was large on teeth, as we can see right here. Same old plot. The mortgage on the farm. Marry me or lose your home. This has been going on in Terry Toons since the 1930s and probably went right back to the silent days. This is Paul Terry's personal aesthetic. He was into the arcane. He was into the theatrics that he was growing up with, having been born in the 1880s. He never really changed. Imagine that on a big screen. Not sure who this animator is. I see him a lot. Yes, but get the villain out. Yes, same old plot. Leave my home and never come back. And now we've got the race. Jim Tyre, who else? And here, I think some drawings here look like Reuben Timmons. Not sure about the whole scene. But right here, I think. It's kind of alarming to see Oil Can Harry without any clothes on. He looks like a normal cat, quote-unquote. Now, again, we're using the Overture to Zampa by Ferdinand Harold, but shortened down to kind of a foxtrot version. Tyre again, using his own logic. The character, he's just all over the place, and yet it makes its own kind of sense. If you didn't have the right timing, that was an error. Didn't have the right kind of timing, these drawings would be a hash. It wouldn't even appear to move. He knew the right spacing, and it can read, and it's absurd and funny. The flags are moving there in the background. That was a lavish touch. Now, these situations with the radio announcer and the knights getting repaired by, modern-day means, Timmons. Let's see. The first cartoon I've seen with it is the Goofy cartoon, Night for a Day. And that spun off a lot of funnier cartoons from other studios. Warner Brothers did one. And now there's a dynamic entrance by Mighty Mouse. Yes, very. And here, this is Timmons kind of being as absurd as he would when he worked with Tyre. Sometimes they split scenes. But about the night thing, Terry did, of course, this one, and there was one with Popeye as well. The incongruity of making a tournament, a medieval tournament, into a modern-day sports event. That's a little with the horses, a little unplanned. But now we're getting kind of Rosinski here. could be him. It might be someone just doing him. Now, again, this scene, I think, is probably by him. And now we get some more Paul Summer. The move is kind of softer and more literal. They must have known how old-fashioned this was, how they had done it a million times. Oh my goodness. Yes, their tire is hamming it up as if he's, used to and maybe even tired of the cliches. But they really, here we go. They hammed it up, and it was a crazy cartoon that on many levels worked. Thank you very much. Good night.